How do you maintain a state of inner peace amongst all the challenges of life?
To maintain inner peace, it is so important that you are present. Yes, there is time on your planet. Although time is an illusion, the past and the present, the past and the future is an illusion. And the more that you connect to the truth of the present, of being present, there is no other choice for you to feel inner peace. And of course, you are going to be sitting with yourself in the present, and many things and emotions and feelings and thoughts may arise. And it's a matter of accepting as well all that is. And in that process, you may even laugh at all that arises and all the worries that you may put on all the things that may be happening in your life. And then you realize how your all that is, it is being a frequency match to who you are being. So it is so important that you are present, that you cultivate that inner peace so that you can create more of that in your external reality.
Why do we suffer in life?
You suffer in life because there is a choice. It is a choice to come to a planet of duality, a planet of contrast. And the level of suffering is also a choice. You may choose to suffer because of certain situations, or you may choose to just surrender and trust that there is a lesson or whatever it is that there is for you there. So remembering that suffering, a lot of the times, not all the time, a lot of the times is a choice.
How do you approach the concept of ego and its role in the spiritual evolution?
Well, the ego is very much part of humans, and many humans will live only an ego-based life in their current lifetime. And ego is there as also part of the contrast to support humans to evolve and ascend. Because the more you observe your human self, your ego self, you are then able to see the contrast experience of it, which is your spiritual self, which is beyond the veil of illusion. So the ego, you could say, it is an experience of who you are not, so that you have the duality, contrasting experience to discover who you truly are.
How do you quiet the negative voices in our head?
There are many ways. A lot of the negative voices in humans' head is because of a dysregulated nervous system. So it can be something quite physiological, and it can also be related to trauma, childhood trauma, ancestral trauma, and also beliefs from society, religious beliefs. So it is a matter of going to the unconscious root of why those negative thoughts are there in the first place. A lot of the times, we could even say most of the times, those thoughts are there because of an unconscious pattern that is running in the background. So as long as that unconscious pattern is dealt with, then the thought, new thoughts can start to come in.
How can we heal physical and emotional pain and suffering in this life?
Well, our last answer to your last question is very much related to this as well. A lot of emotional and physical pain exists due to unconscious pattern. So an example that Rubia usually gives is a visual example is when you think about the We are having trouble remembering the word. When you think about outside of the water, that ice, there is ice outside of the water, and then in the water, the iceberg. You only see the tip of the iceberg outside of the water, and then underneath the water, there is this huge iceberg. And that is 90% of what is controlling your life, is that we would say that what is underneath the water is your unconscious mind that is creating the emotional and the physical pain. So as long as you are addressing those patterns, you are then able to shift once and for all the emotional and the physical pain, alongside with some lifestyle changes and also with some mindset reprogramming. So starting to cultivate new neural pathways so that you're able to then create a new you that doesn't have the emotional and the physical pain.
To watch the full video, click on the link below. And don't forget to subscribe.